Hello all, hope you're enjoying Summit so far. I'm going to talk to you about Kubo. It's a tale of three products, many names. My name is Kira Boyle. I work for Pivotal. I work on a project called PCF Health Watch, which is a closed source graphical representation of some of the key performance indicators coming through Cloud Foundry. If you're interested in that, come talk to me, because that's not what this talk is about. So what is Kubo? Kubo, as we learned in the keynote this morning, is going to be called the container runtime, and it's going to be deployed alongside the application runtime, which is what we now know as Cloud Foundry, and those are both going to be deployed on Bosch. Pivotal also offers a closed source offering of Kubo, and that's going to be called the Pivotal Container Service, or PKS, because Google. So exactly what is Kubo? Kubo is a joint effort of Google and Pivotal to create a Bosch-powered web-scale release engineering for Kubernetes. What that basically means is you want to run Kubernetes and you want to run Cloud Foundry, but you can't monitor Kubernetes, so you're going to run it on Bosch. So then that should lead you to your next question of, well, what exactly is Bosch? We have the old Bosch logo and the new Bosch logo. What is Bosch? It's a lifecycle management tool that was created for Cloud Foundry to basically streamline their deployment process, because I don't know if anybody has tried to deploy Cloud Foundry. If they've deployed it in the past, it was a really big mess even with Bosch, and as they've developed into the new Bosch 2 CLI, it's become leaps and bounds better to deploy Cloud Foundry. It operates on four basic principles. Those principles are that it wants it to be identifiable, so you have all of your properties, you have all of your networks, you have what all of your specific IaaS information, those are going to be stored in a base manifest and now DevOps files, and you can deploy those and say, I have all of these ops files, I want to do those again and again and again. When I do those again and again and again, I want them to do the same thing every time, and I want it to be fast. So Bosch allows you to have all of these things so that when you deploy your products today, when you deploy them tomorrow, when you deploy them next week, you're going to get the same results every single time. So the next question is, what is Kubernetes? Kubernetes was created by Google. It was meant to be more of a container management tool, so as opposed to Bosch, which is more around VMs and spinning up new VMs for each of your new pieces. Kubernetes is all about like, okay, I'm going to deal with the VMs. All you're going to deal about is all your different containers. The things it cares most about is it wants you to be able to deploy quickly and it wants you to deploy predictably. You want to be able to scale your applications at will. You want to be able to roll out your new features very quickly, very seamlessly. And you also want to be able to like limit your hardware usage for required resources. For those of you who are more familiar with Cloud Foundry, it's kind of like Diego, but different. But if that kind of gives you like an entry point into kind of what Kubernetes does, if you can imagine it that way. So what else does Kubernetes do? Pretty cool. It prides itself in being portable, so you can use it in a private cloud, public cloud, hybrid, multi-cloud. It believes also in being extensible, so it wants to be very pluggable, hookable, able to be in multiple places, and it also wants to be self-healing. So it wants to be able to restart applications, auto-scale applications, and main thing. So that should get you thinking, that sounds kind of like Cloud Foundry, so is this a competitor to Cloud Foundry? And I want to tell you, no. Kubo is meant to be deployed alongside Kubernetes, and because they're so similar, they can be used in very similar ways. Both are going to be managed by Bosch, so you can use Bosch to monitor the health of your Kubernetes cluster, and you can use Kubernetes to deploy things that maybe Cloud Foundry could not. So what does this look like? So if you look here, you have like your big Bosch network. You have your Kubo subnet over here, and you've got your Cloud Foundry subnet over here. So how does Kubernetes talk to Cloud Foundry? Well, Kubernetes is going to come up here and make a request to your load balancer, which is then going to be able to talk to the TCP router in your Cloud Foundry instances. So as it's directing all of its traffic through the Cloud Foundry router, you can have things deployed on Kubernetes talking to your apps deployed on Cloud Foundry, and it's really cool. So an example of like, what does this look like? Because you say before, oh, well, shouldn't I be able to deploy anything on Cloud Foundry? I could just make a Bosch release and have it work. So take, for example, CockroachDB. Doesn't really have a good Bosch release. Say maybe it does have a Bosch release now and it doesn't do everything you want it to. But it's got a really good, You want to deploy it on Cloud Foundry. Cloud Foundry says no because of its Bosch release. But you do have CockroachDB. You say, I want to use it. but Kubernetes can deploy it. So you deploy your Kubernetes on Bosch, and because you've already set up the routing I described earlier, you have Kubernetes that's now able to talk to Cloud Foundry. And because Kubernetes can talk to Cloud Foundry, CockroachDB is deployed to Kubernetes, you can now have them all communicating on one big happy network. So this is just a resource dump page. This is available on my speaker page. Don't feel like super stressed out about it. It's just got a lot of really great tutorials, like learning a lot about Bosch, about Kubo, about Kubernetes. Like, they're three very heavy topics, and it's hard to just get it all down in a lightning talk, but I really encourage you to do some more research into it. A couple of these videos here were actually using Cloud Foundry with Kubernetes. Highly recommend those. I think they were from other Cloud Foundry talks. And there were also some earlier today. If you missed those, I'm sure they'll be available later. And I think there's also one tomorrow. So I encourage you to attend those. And that is all. Thank you.